Hello, welcome back dear student. This is Deepak Sutaria from Vasishta Vidyalay. Last time we have discussed about crop production and management. The topics are introduction, kharif crops, rabi crops, preparation of soil, agricultural implements, adding manure. And right now we are going to talk about adding fertilizer. So let's move further. Fertilizers are chemical substances which are rich in particular nutrients. How they are different from manure? Fertilizers are produced in factories. Some example of fertilizers are urea, ammonium sulfate, superphosphate, potash, and NPK means nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. The use of fertilizer has helped farmers to get better yield of crops such as wheat, paddy, and maize. But excessive use of fertilizer has made the soil less fertile. Fertilizer have also become a source of water pollution. Therefore, in order to maintain the fertility of the soil, we have to substitute fertilizer with organic manure or leave the field uncultivated in between two crops. The use of manure improves soil texture as well as its water retaining capacity. It replacement the soil with nutrients. Now let's perform an activity: growing seeds with manure and fertilizer. Procedure: first of all, take mung gram seeds and germinate them. Select equal size seeding. Take 3 empty glasses, mark them ABC. Next, add soil mix with cow dung manure in A, soil mix with urea in B, and same amount of soil in C. Pour same quantity of water in all. Now keep them at a safe place and continue watering daily for 7 to 10 days. Now observe and compare with their growth. Here you can observe that in the glass B, the growth is much more than glass A and B. A and C. This is the glass containing soil and fertilizer. Advantage of manure over fertilizer. In order to maintain the fertility of the soil, we have to substitute fertilizer with organic manure or leave the field uncultivated in between two crops. The organic manure is considered better than fertilizer. This is because provide lots of humus to soil, enhance water holding capacity of the soil. It loosens soil so that root can breathe easily. It increases useful microbes in soil and improve soil texture. Now another method of replenishing the soil with nutrients is through crop rotation. This can be done by growing different crops alternatively. Earlier, farmer in the northern India used to grow legumes as fodder in one season and wheat in the next season. This helped in the replenishment of soil with nitrogen. Farmers are being encouraged to adopt this practice. Our next topic is irrigation. All living beings needs water to live. Water is an important for proper growth and development. Water is absorbed by the plant's roots. Along with water, minerals and fertilizer are also absorbed. Plants contain nearly 90% of water. Water is essential because germination of seeds does not take place under dry conditions. Nutrients dissolved in water are transported to each part of the plants. Water also protects the crop from both frost and hot air currents. To maintain the moisture of the soil for healthy crop growth, fields have to be watered regularly. The supply of water to crop at regular interval is called irrigation. The time and frequency of irrigation varies from crop to crop, soil to soil, and season to season. In summer, the frequency of watering is higher. Why is it so? Could it be due to the increased rate of evaporation of water from the soil and leaves? Source of irrigation. The source of water for irrigations are wells, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers, dams, and canals. Traditional method of irrigation. The water available in wells lakes and canal is lifted up by different method in different region for taking it to the field. Cattle or human labor is used in this method. So this method are cheaper but less efficient. The various traditional ways are mud pulley system. Second is chain pump. Third is Dhekli and Rahat layer system. Pumps are commonly used for lifting water. Diesel, biogas, electricity and solar energy is used to run these pumps. Modern methods of irrigation. Modern methods of irrigation help us to use water economically. The main method used are as follow. First is sprinkler system. This system is more useful on the uneven land where sufficient water is not available. The perpendicular pipes having rotating nozzles on the top are joined to main pipeline at regular intervals. When water is allowed to flow through the main pipeline under pressure with the help of pump, it escapes from the rotating nozzle. It gets sprinkled on the crop as if it is raining. Sprinkler is very useful for lawn, coffee plantation and several other crops. Next method is drip system. In this system, the water falls drop by drop directly near the roots. So it is called drip system. It is the best technique for watering fruits, plants, gardens and trees where water is not wasted at all. It is a boon in region where availability of water is very poor. Next topic is protection from weeds. In a field, many other undesirable plants may grow naturally along with the crop. These undesirable plants are called weeds. The removal of weeds is called weeding. Weeding is necessary since weeds compete with the crop plants for water, nutrients, space and light. Thus, they affect the growth of the crop. Some weeds interfere even in harvesting and may be poisonous for animals and human beings. Farmers adopt many ways to remove weeds and control their growth. Tilling before sowing up crops helps in uprooting and killing of weeds, which may then dry up and get mixed with the soil. The best time for removal of seeds is before they produce flowers and seeds. The manual removal includes physical removal of weeds by uprooting or cutting them close to the ground from time to time. This is done with the help of khurpi. A seed drill is also used to uproot the weeds. Weeds are also controlled by using certain chemicals called weedicides like 2,4-D. These are sprayed in the field to kill the weeds. They do not damage the crops. The weedicides are diluted with water to extent required and sprayed in the field with a sprayer. Do weedicides have any effect on person handling the weedicide sprayer? Student, I have only told that the weedicides are sprayed during the vegetative growth of weeds before flowering and seeds formation. Spraying of weedicides may affect the health of the farmers. So they have to use this chemical very carefully. They should cover their nose and mouth with the piece of cloth during spraying of these chemicals. So in this way we can protect the weeds.